Carlos Contralegaspi for ESPN Deportes with the featherweight champion Alexander Volkanovski, who is back in Abu Dhabi. Alex, you were there last year. The conditions are obviously completely different this time. Tell me about this craziness, about the call, about taking this fight. And was this the fight that you were like hoping to have after you won an international fight? Where you were hoping to have this rematch?
After Yair Rodriguez, this is a fight that I did want. We did ask for it, seeing if we could do it, but obviously we're told that they'll go on with Charles. So and obviously I need to do surgery and all that. So so they were with Charles. So I didn't think this was going to happen. I thought I was going to be in on January, but then I got the phone call 12 days out that it was happening. So I was like, okay, let's go. Maybe it is happening.
Everyone is talking about all the risks that you're taking, right? Like not in camp. It's obviously an opponent that you know, but it's not easy to take a fight against Islam at any time, and especially with such a short notice. So was this like an opportunity that you thought that, I mean, having Charles, having Justin, having all these guys like line up, is something that you thought that it would take a lot longer to get another shot at 155 if you didn't take this one?
Yeah, man. Well, that's it. You know, nothing's ever really promised, right? Like, so this come up and I obviously wanted the challenge. I thought this is an incredible challenge. I thought, you know, the high risk, high reward, you know, I thrive in these situations. So I wanted to take it on, knowing that at least I'm guaranteed this rematch. Because you never know. You never know what happens with his fights, whether he moves up and then he's not in lightweight anymore and whatnot. But this is guarantees me a rematch, so I'm going to take it.
So what is moving you more this time? To have the second belt or the rematch in a fight that you were, like, you felt so close to win? A lot of people saw you winning on those cards and on in February. So is this more about having your rematch and finally defeating Islam, or getting that second belt that is obviously huge for your legacy?
It's all of it. Obviously, the rematch is probably bigger to me than the belt. But, I mean, there's obviously a lot of big things that come out of this. You know, I'm chasing greatness and I'm chasing a lot of things. So now with this fight that come up, I get to chase not only the lightweight belt and be double champ, I'm chasing the rematch to avenge the loss. And not only that, there's so much more the story behind, obviously 12 days and the challenges doing it over there in Abu Dhabi and, you know, over here in Abu Dhabi, all these things, you know what I mean? It just shows you who I am and what I'm all about. And it's obviously got people talking, and going out there and do what I plan on doing is going to really get people talking. You know what I mean? I want to go out there and I want to finish him and really try and separate myself from the rest.
You proved last time that you could hurt him, and I seen you spoke a couple of times that this time you need to finish because you don't want to, like, leave it to the judges. How hard is that? How hard is to finish someone like Islam? You been there in the case with him for like 25 minutes. How much do you have to change this time the strategy to get this finish, to get the knockout?
Yeah, man. Like, I do need to change some things up. He's not easy to be finished. It's still going to be a tough fight and obviously a tough task at hand. But again, I love a challenge. I love doing that. And yeah, as I've been saying all week, you know, I haven't had time to prepare for the worst. I can only prepare for what I plan on doing, you know what I mean? So I'm going to go full steam ahead on that. I think to really set a real statement, and already what I'm doing is incredible, but this whole rivalry, to go out there and knock him out in Abu Dhabi would just be, mate, like one of the biggest things you can do in this sport, you know what I mean? And, you know, again, I'm trying to chase some big things, and me doing that is one of them. So I'm going to go full steam ahead, and I believe I can do it. And that's exactly what I'm going to go for Saturday night.
It's definitely something that everyone will remember. You do it like in such a short notice, someone like so dominant like Islam, and if you get that second belt. Now, I'm going to go to what was happening for January. I have you felt like the passion that the Spaniards have for Ilia yet in your social media? And when it was like rumor, it was like planned to having you fighting against Topuria in January. Have you felt that the needle he's moving in Spain with all his following?
Yeah, like, well, I don't know if I felt it, but, you know, I hear that He's got a big following and whatnot, and obviously people want to see the fight. And I do see that people do want to see the fight. People are excited for it, so I noticed that. I probably don't know the details on like what he's got behind him, but I still see that there's obviously hype around him, which excites me. He likes to talk as well. He's undefeated, so there's a lot of interesting things about that, especially featherweight. For me, it's exciting. It really is exciting, and I think that fight would bring some hype. So I was looking forward to that in January, but now I've got to worry about this. I'll do this, and then we'll try and make that happen still in January. Anyway.
I feel like I asked you this like a few months before when you were to fight Islam and then seemed like Jair was lined up. It's something guaranteed for you. Like you want to still fight for the 145 if you win in this Saturday.
Oh, of course, of course. I definitely want to fight. I wanted to keep both divisions busy, I really do. And as I said, I mentioned that today about me in the last year, since July last year, I've made weight for every lightweight and featherweight fight in the last since last July. I've been every single one. I was here. I turned up to make weight last year on in Abu Dhabi. I was ready. Remember, I was a backup, so I made weight. And then every fight that was, including this Saturday, I've been involved with lightweight and featherweight. So saying that I can't keep two divisions busy is just crazy because I've been doing that for the last year.
So January is still the plan. Whether it's Topuria or not, you still want to go back in January.
Yes, definitely. 100%.
Well, Alexander, definitely it's something historical you're trying to pull this Saturday. Hope we have a great fight and hope the people in Abu Dhabi enjoys it.
No worries. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thanks a lot, Alex.
All right. Thank you. See you.